So in this class we'll be studying, we'll be discussing what is the syllabus and overview of the syllabus. So this veterinary pharmacology and toxicology annual syllabus, you are knowing that it's 4+1 credit hours course, and 5 teachers from our department, myself, Dr. Archana, Dr. Anjana, Dr. Rashmi and Dr. Nirala, we all will be teaching different aspects, different contents of this syllabus. So, if you see, you are studying VCI as per Minimum Standards of Veterinary Education 2016 syllabus. So, based on this syllabus, your theory and practical, there are 6 units in theory and there are 5 units in practical syllabus. So, the first unit is that of general pharmacology in theory. The second unit is autonomic nervous system pharmacology. Third unit is central nervous system pharmacology. Fourth unit is pharmacology of the different body systems. Fifth unit is veterinary chemotherapy. And the sixth is veterinary toxicology. We'll be discussing what are these words and what these relate with. And in the practical, you are having general pharmacology, autonomic nervous system pharmacology, central nervous system pharmacology, chemotherapy and toxicology. So coming to one by one, the first unit which we are discussing, I'll be teaching the first unit. So it will take approximately 20 classes to complete this first unit of general pharmacology. So what we'll be studying in general pharmacology, let's have a brief review. So we have discussed the introductory portions, and today we are discussing the syllabus. After today's class, in the next class, we'll be discussing the historical developments. We should know history of each and of any subject. History of parasitology, history of pathology. We should know whatever developments that has taken place till date in the science. Who are the contributors? Who are the people who have worked over this? So history we should know. At least we should acknowledge the contributors who have contributed to the development of science. And we'll be discussing the branches and scope of pharmacology. Sources and nature of drugs, pharmacological different terms and definitions. So this will be the overall introductory syllabus. Apart from this, this in the general pharmacology, now this general pharmacology is subdivided into 2 main branches. First is pharmacokinetics and the second is pharmacodynamics. So we had defined these 2 words in the last class. So we'll be studying in detail the pharmacokinetics. Pharmacokinetics includes 4 processes that I had discussed in the last class: absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. So all these 4 processes will be studying in great detail, how absorption goes on and all these things. And before absorption, before any drug is being absorbed, it needs to be administered either by oral route, either by intramuscular route, either by subcutaneous route. So we'll be studying also the routes of administration. So the second aspect of general pharmacology is pharmacodynamics. So in pharmacodynamics, as we had discussed in the last class, we'll be studying the dynamicity of the drug, which relates to its action, its efficacy, its mechanism of action, its toxicity, what are the different targets or receptors where the drug binds. So these aspects, what are the adverse drug reactions, toxicities. So these aspects will be studying in pharmacodynamics. So for discussion of all these topics, some 20 classes will be required. So I think I think we can cover before Deepavali. I'll finish all these things before Deepavali. So the second unit is autonomic nervous system pharmacology. And you might have studied in the physiology, what is autonomic nervous system. So the we'll be discussing some aspects of certain aspects of physiology of each and every system. But since this is class of pharmacology, so myself or my colleague, nobody will be discussing in great length physiology. We'll be presuming that you have studied physiology because you are in the 3rd professional year. You have studied anatomy, physiology. You can understand pharmacology only if you are having and you are knowing anatomy and physiology of the animal system. So regarding the autonomic nervous system pharmacology, Dr. Rashmi will be taking, and also it is at par with the first unit. Some 20 lectures will be required. Basically, in the syllabus, we'll be discussing the different aspects of autonomic nervous system. You might have studied in physiology, neurohumoral transmission, how nerve impulses are being transmitted across in the axons and across the synapses, and the pharmacology of different types of neurotransmitters. What are the neurotransmitters in autonomic nervous system, and from where they attach, from where it is synthesized, and from how it is released, how it is degraded. All the pharmacology we'll be discussing. And what are the drugs which modify their storage, synthesis, release, or destruction? All these aspects we'll be discussing. So now these autonomic drugs act on different set of receptors called as adrenergic receptors and cholinergic receptors. So we'll be discussing the different aspects of adrenergic and cholinergic receptors also. In the second component in autonomic nervous system pharmacology, the second component is autoacquired pharmacology. Now this autoacquired pharmacology, now these autoacquireds are some, you can say, inflammatory mediators, some sort of inflammatory mediators and some local hormones, or you can say local hormones, like you must be knowing a lot of inflammatory mediators like histamine, prostaglandins, and eicosanoids, and a lot of things are there. Apart from that, angiotensin, bradykinin, and all these things, they regulate a lot of body functions in our body, and we'll be discussing their pharmacology. So this will be the completion of unit 2, and in the unit third unit, this is the pharmacology of central nervous system. So Dr. Nirala will be taking this unit this time, and also it will take some 20 classes. Well, this 20 class may go in 22, 24, 25. This is the approximation. Normally it should be covered within this time of time. So in the central nervous system pharmacology, you will be studying different drugs which act on the central nervous system. Now you know that central nervous system is consists of brain and spinal cord. So a lot of drugs act on these portions of the body. A lot of, as you know that if you are taking any anesthetic, you get anesthetized, you are not aware of the surroundings. If your hand is being incised or cut, you are not having any feeling of pain. And so how anesthesia is being set, and what are the different aspects of anesthesia, what are the different anesthetics, how, in what doses it should be used, and in what cases it should not be used. So all these aspects will be studied in the in this particular semester under unit 3. Apart from anesthetics, we will be studying different hypnotic and sedative drugs, some tranquilizer drugs. You must be knowing narcoanalysis test. Some police normally conduct a narco test over some criminals. So what this narco test is all about, how narcosis happens, what are the drugs which influence the behavior of our central nervous system, how our central nervous system is being depressed, all these aspects will be studying under this unit 3. Apart from that, we'll be studying some local anesthetics and some other drugs also. So in unit 4, we'll be studying pharmacology of different body systems. In physiology, you have studied that a lot of body systems are there. Say for example, digestive system is there, respiratory system is there, urogenital system is there, endocrines are there. So we have to study, what we study in pharmacology, we try to modify the different body functions. Say for example, you have studied the physiology of digestive system, and you know that how peristaltic movement goes on, how ingesta, how food you are taking, how it passes from one part of the digestive system and crosses, and how it is digested and how it is passed through stool. So you are knowing the physiology, how it happens. Now the question is, if the peristaltic movement or if the bowel movement is increased, or as in case of diarrhea, as in case of shooting diarrhea, how you can control, and what should be the mechanisms, how we can, one mechanism we can think at this moment, that if the bowel movement or the peristaltic movement is increased, we can control the voluntary, involuntary muscles of the GI tract. We can do something so that they don't contract at that time. So we can give drugs which can control these activities. there is a problem of dehydration, excessive fluid loss. So all these aspects we'll be discussing in the digestive system. Apart from that, cardiovascular system, respiratory system, lot of diseases are there related to cardiovascular system. You might be knowing that related to blood vessels, a very big problem in human beings, hypertension, blood pressure. So how to control, what are the drugs which we can use in cases of hypertension, in case of cardiac anomalies, and all these things related to blood clotting and all these things we'll be discussing in the cardiovascular system. So under respiratory system, in cold seasons, you are having sore throat, you are having some sneezing problems, you are having rhinitis, you are having some coughing. So how to control all these disease conditions, we'll be discussing under respiratory system. So in urinary system and in genital system, since anatomically these are related, so we'll be discussing urogenital system at a time. And in genital system, we can study in animals, ecbolics, or the oxytocins, which contract the uterine activity, which relax the uterine activity, like tocolytic drugs. In urinary system, we can have diuretics. There are a lot of cases where the whole body is edematous, where the whole body is swollen, and you need to, there is a localized accumulation of body fluids. You need to drain it from your body. So some drugs like diuretics can be given, which will wash these. So what are the applications, in what cases diuretics and all these things should be given, we'll be discussing under urogenital system. Apart from that, this fluid and electrolyte balance, whenever you go to any hospital, whatever the doctor or the compounder, first of all, it will give you IV drip. So what is the concept of intravenous fluid therapy? In what cases it should be given? In what doses it should be given? What are the different kinds of fluids which you should give? So all these things we'll be studying under fluid and electrolyte therapy. What are the different electrolytes and fluids we should use, and in what condition we should use? So apart from that, a lot of hormones are there. And if there is a hormonal imbalance in the body, if there is hormonal deficiency or the requirement of exogenous hormones to be given, we'll discuss under pharmacology of hormones. And apart from that, you feel a lot of skin disorders are there, a lot of ointments, creams, and all these things. So we'll be discussing drugs acting on skin and mucous membranes. So this will form the part of systemic pharmacology, which Dr. Archana will be teaching you. So the fifth unit is very important, veterinary chemotherapy. And this section includes different chemotherapeutic agents. So myself and Dr. Anjana, since it's a big topic, some 40 lectures will be required to complete this unit. And this will include different antibiotics, all the antibiotics which you are using right now, like sulfonamides, penicillins, cephalosporins, aminoglycosides, tetracyclines, fluoroquinolones. So big list is there. We'll be teaching you in great detail. By the end of this year, you will be having a very good knowledge of pharmacology, and you will be having developing some confidence that you can prescribe medicines to the patients. So knowledge of pharmacology is very much important, because you cannot be a good doctor if you are not having knowledge of drugs or the medicines. What you'll be prescribing? If any patient comes to you, forget prescribing to animals, for treatment of yourself. Whenever you feel that if you visit to any doctor and the doctor prescribes some medicines, that better you take these medicines morning, evening. You should know what these medicines, what these drugs, how they work in your body, and whether the doctor is giving proper medicine or not. At least you can treat yourself. For that sake, at least from today onwards, you should know whatever medicine you are taking, see the composition of the medicine, then try to see what is the mechanism of action of this drug, how it works in our body, in what dosage it should be given, what are the different side effects of this drug. All these things need to be, you should know. And it's not a one-day experience. You need to study all these things, and lot of drugs, more than thousands of drugs you have to study. And you have to memorize the doses and the mechanism of action and the toxicity and all these things, you may be confused. So you don't be worried. It's a daily practice. Day by day, you in one day you learn about one drug. The second day you learn about the second drug. So during a time course, when you take the degree of graduation, BBS and MBA, by that time you will be having knowledge of all these things, but not the full confidence and experience. So after the internship program, you will be prescribing all these things along with your senior doctors, and by that time you will be having confidence. So that's not an issue. In chemotherapy, apart from these antibiotics, we'll be discussing other chemotherapeutic agents also, like antifungal agents, like anthelmintic agents. There are a lot of helminth parasites which you need to kill them if you want to cope up with these with those helminth parasites. Apart from that, there are antiviral agents, like globally people are searching for anti-COVID because this what are the drugs which can kill this COVID virus. So a lot of viruses are there, and there are a lot of antiviral drugs. Apart from that, cancer is a big problem. So anti-cancer drugs are also a part of chemotherapeutic, are also chemotherapeutic. So treatment of cancer also will be discussing under chemotherapy. So apart from that, anti-tuberculosis drugs, anthelmintics, anti-protozoal drugs, all these drugs will be studying under chemotherapy. And since we have studied a lot of drugs, and till unit 5, unit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have discussed a lot of drugs, and each and every drug is having its own side effect or the toxicity. So in the unit 6, we'll be studying toxicology of different drugs. Toxicology, nowadays, pharmacology is a basic subject. Pharmacology deals with pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of all the drugs, whether it is a drug acting on the digestive system, whether it is a drug acting on the cardiovascular system, whether it is an antibiotic or an antifungal drug. We'll be studying the pharmacology, means pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. Pharmacokinetics means how it is being absorbed, distributed, metabolized, and eliminated from the body. Pharmacodynamics, how the drug acts over the body, what is that side effect, and all these things. These aspects everywhere you have to study. Now, so what I'm saying, pharmacology is a basic subject, and in toxicology is an applied subject. Nowadays, you feel that whatever you doctor, if any doctor is prescribing, you might be saying, thinking that the drug should be safe. I should not have any side effect. If I'm taking any drug for 7 days, there should not be any hair loss or any allergy or pruritus condition or any toxicity or liver toxicity. Each and every person wants to have safe medicines. So safety nowadays is a great concern. And as I had told in the last class, that all these drugs, since these they are not self to the body, they will induce some or the other kind of toxicity in your body. All drugs will have some or the other side effects. So side effects is a big problem. If you are not having any disease, you should not take any medicine or any drug. Because if you are taking, it will either damage liver, either damage kidney, either it will depress your erythropoietic system, it will do some or the other damage. That's very sure. No any drug is 100% safe. Obviously, some drugs are safer. They're having lesser toxicity. But no any drug is free of any side effect. So we have to study toxicology. We have to know the toxicity. What is the toxicity? Kya damage karega? Kya problem mere ko hoga? I should know so that I can manage the toxicity. If any drug is causing liver damage, say for example, anti-tubercular drugs. For treatment of tuberculosis, the drug has to be given minimum for a period of 6 months. Because this Mycobacterium tuberculosis is a very tough organism. It doesn't die within 7 days or 10 days. So if you are taking the anti-tubercular drugs for 6 months, your liver will be compromised. So you have to protect your liver by giving hepatoprotective agents. So you should know what is the toxicity and how you will manage the toxicity. That's why toxicology is important. Toxicology is also important that you are nowadays you are using lot of toxicants in your body. You are surrounded by a lot of toxicants. I can tell you are using paints. That those paints in your contain lead, mercury they contain. And if you are accidentally, your animal consumes that paint, your animal will be poisoned and serious symptoms of toxicosis will come. You have to offer treatment. If any person takes any poison, घर में झगड़ा होता है ना, कुछ झगड़ा हो गया, पंगे हो गए और पॉइजन खा लिया, डॉक्टर तो उसको इलाज करना पड़ेगा. उस डॉक्टर को जानना होगा कि किस पॉइजन का क्या सिम्टम होता है और उसका एंटीडोट क्या है. सो दैट इज वाई टॉक्सिकोलॉजी इज इम्पोर्टेंट. टॉक्सिकोलॉजी इम्पोर्टेंट है. हमारे आस पास में सो मेनी प्लांट्स हैं, बहुत जहरीले पौधे भी हैं. अगर हमारे एनिमल्स गलती से उनको खा लें तो उनकी टॉक्सिटी होगी. आपको जानना होगा कि उसका क्या एंटीडोटल मेजर्स होंगे. अगर टॉक्सिकोसिस हो गया तो कैसे उसको रिवर्ट करें. अगर स्नेक बाइट हो जाए, सांप काट ले, स्कॉर्पियन बाइट हो जाए, बीस बैस अगर प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ, आई एम गेटिंग सम बैकग्राउंड नॉइज. सो अगर किसी को मधुमक्खी ने पूरा जंक काट लिया है तो कैसे उसका ट्रीटमेंट करेंगे, उसका चेहरा. तो दीज थिंग्स यू हैव टू विल बी स्टडीइंग इन टॉक्सिकोलॉजी. सो बेसिकली दीज आर द सिक्स यूनिट्स विल बी स्टडीइंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर ईयर इन वेटरनरी फार्माकोलॉजी एंड टॉक्सिकोलॉजी. नाउ आई एम हैविंग सम 5-6 मिनट्स, वी कैन टेक अप सम क्वेश्चंस एंड वी वुड लाइक टू कंक्लूड दिस क्लास. And in the next class, we'll be studying in detail. We'll be studying the main business, and we'll be starting with the history of pharmacology. So, if you have any doubt, clarification, any type of question which you are, which is being arising in your mind, you can discuss. We can take up some 2-3-4 questions. Yes.
Sir, please. What is the difference between antidote and antibody?
Antidote and antibody. Okay. Antidote. What this word denotes? Anti means opposite. Antidote means anything which is antagonizing anybody. Say for example, in your batch also, some people may not be having good friendship with the others. So the other is antidote of the first one. Antidote is just antagonist or opposite of anything, right? Antibody is antigen. Antibody, you might have studied immunology. So antibodies are immunoglobulins, or they are proteinaceous molecules. They are generated in response to some antigens. So antigens, antibodies, you can say they are antidotes to some antigens. But antidote is a broad word. Say for example, I have taken some poison. Some snake bite is there. So anti-snake venom is the antidote for those snake poisons. Some there is a long list of antidotes. Some poisons, this drug is antidote of this poison, this antidote is poison of this, the antidote of this poison. So antidotes typically means antagonist or opposite of anything, whereas
so it is not part of antibody and against of antigen.
Please repeat your question.
Is it a part of antibody or it is prepared with a weakened antigen? And what? How can I? I'm not so clear about antidote.
Okay, actually, you know antibody, na? Antibody.
Yes, sir.
You know antigen, antibody.
Yes, sir.
So antigens normally they are some proteins, or they are some of either bacteria or virus, either of the nuclear material or of the cell wall or from some anywhere of the microbes, and if they are being administered to the human or the animal body, the immune response will be excited, will be elicited, and some antagonists of these antigens, which we popularly say is as antibodies, they will be generated by the betas, by the plasma cells or the concerned cells of our body. So antibodies are immune, or of immune nature, whereas in antidote is a general term. Antibody is also one type of, you can say, antidote, which will neutralize the respective antigens. If the antigen is Yes, Pallavi?
Yes, sir. I'm listening you. Proceed.
So you better study because there is a time limitation. We cannot discuss at length. You study about antigen, antibody, and you study about antidotes. Antidotes are general terms, and it includes broad range of things. For example, if you have been bitten by some acid attack over your hand, and that acid is hydrochloric acid, how will you neutralize? Immediately you need some alkali to neutralize this thing. So this alkali will be antidote of the acid. So antidote is simply anything opposite. Got it?
It is not proteinaceous. It may be proteinaceous or not.
It may be anything. I'm saying it may be anything. You tell me, sodium hydroxide is protein or not protein?
No, it's not protein.
It will neutralize hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid. So yes, antidote is a general word. It includes any number of things, anything. Whereas antibody is a very specialized kind of thing. So that is the difference. Any other question we can, anybody?
Sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Is toxicology a branch of pharmacology?
Just a moment, since one minute time is there. So if it ends, you will continue with the same ID after 3-4 minutes because the recording is going on, and we'll take up your remaining questions. Okay. So I'm ending this meeting right now, and after 2-3 minutes, you again log in and we'll take up your question. Okay. Yes. What was the question? Who was asking anything?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I was asking that, is toxicology a branch of pharmacology?
Pharmacology, in that way you can say, pharmacology, you can say, that's a tough question you have asked. Actually,
I have read somewhere that toxicology is a branch.
Actually, in the next class, we'll be discussing history of pharmacology. Thereafter, whenever theory class will be held, we'll discuss branches and scope of pharmacology. So, when I will discuss that, this particular doubt will be cleared. If you take up in a broader way, toxicology is a branch of pharmacology. But nowadays, this branch has become such a big branch that it is at par with pharmacology, and in future pharmacology will be a smaller subject and this sub branch toxicology will become a broad subject, because nowadays we are eating whatever vegetables we are eating lot of pesticides. Bhindi pe jo hai wo agar bhindi ke kheton mein jaake dekho तो पटना के इर्द गिर्द में जो खेती हो रही है, स्प्रे करता है मॉर्निंग में, सामने भिंडी ला करके रखा हुआ ग्रीन, आप उस पेस्टिसाइड कितना भी वॉश करोगे तो भिंडी के अंदर पेस्टिसाइड चला गया, उसको तो हटा नहीं सकते हो। अगर वो 2 दिन पहले किया है तो थोड़ा कम आएगा। तो हर किसी का विड्रॉल पीरियड है, कोई फॉलो नहीं करता है, तो आप एवरीडे पेस्टिसाइड खा रहे हो, पेस्टिसाइड टॉक्सिकोलॉजी आपको पढ़ना पड़ेगा। फिर बहुत सारे ड्रग्स एंटीबायोटिक्स आपके फूड प्रोड्यूसिंग एनिमल्स में यूज हो रहे हैं, जैसे पोल्ट्री बर्ड्स है, उसको वैक्सीन पड़ रहा है, उसको मेडिसिन पड़ रहा है, उसको एवरीडे पड़ रहा है, और 42 दिन पर उसको मार्केट में ले आता है बेचने के लिए। अगर 40वें दिन उसको कोई मेडिसिन पड़ा है ओरली, तो वो आपके मीट के साथ आपको मिलेगा फ्री में, अंडे में फ्री में मिलेगा। गाय अगर बीमार है और दूध दे रही है, उसको एंटीबायोटिक लग रहा है, तो उसके दूध में एंटीबायोटिक भी फ्री में आप पी रहे हो। तो आज पहले ये प्रॉब्लम थोड़ा कम था, लेकिन जैसे हम एडवांस हो रहे हैं, लॉट ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स यूज करते हैं, लॉट ऑफ केमिकल्स यूज करते हैं, हम इर्द गिर्द जैसे हम अभी आपसे कनेक्टेड हैं, तो लैंड नेटवर्क से कनेक्टेड हैं, तो हमारे आसपास सो मेनी रेज हैं, उसी तरीके से हम जो भी खाते पीते नहाते हैं केमिकल से घिरे हुए हैं, और सबका एक ना दूसरा साइड इफेक्ट, लॉन्ग टर्म इफेक्ट तो आएगा ही। तो टॉक्सिकोलॉजी हर किसी को सेफ चाहिए, और सर्टिफाइड फूड डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज में रॉ फूड्स नहीं मिलते, सर्टिफाइड पैक्ड फूड मिलते हैं, उसमें लिखे हुए रहते हैं कि ये पॉइजन का लेवल इतना है, इसका इतना है, इसका इतना है, इसका इतना है, और परमिसिबल लेवल इतना है, परमिसिबल लेवल से कम है, देन यू कैन ईट। तो टॉक्सिकोलॉजी इंपॉर्टेंट है, बैक्टीरियाज का भी बहुत सारे स्कोप है, हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे स्कोप ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी। आप अगर फार्माकोलॉजिस्ट एक टॉक्सिकोलॉजिस्ट होते हो तो फ्यूचर में आपके क्या स्कोप है, सारी चीजें एक क्लास में नहीं डिस्कस करेंगे, अदरवाइज फर्स्ट क्लास में डेफिनेशन है, इस क्लास में आपको सिलेबस बताया, अगले क्लास में थोड़ा हिस्ट्री बताएंगे, तो इन कमिंग 5-10 क्लासेस यू विल हैव अ गुड नॉलेज, आपके बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस क्लियर हो जाएंगे। सो यस, टॉक्सिकोलॉजी इज ए सब ब्रांच ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी। और कोई क्वेश्चन? एनी क्वेश्चन? किसी और का कोई डाउट?
सर, लास्ट लेक्चर में आपने बोला था ड्रग अब्यूज के बारे में, बताओ
इसके बारे में। ड्रग अब्यूज 2-3 मिनट डिस्कस कर सकते हैं, फिर आपको 11 o'clock क्लास है ना, तो आप 11:10:52 हो रहा है, 55 में आपको ब्लॉक कर दें, बंद कर देंगे, ताकि आप नेक्स्ट क्लास के लिए। ड्रग अब्यूज ये जो टर्म है, ड्रग का जो ब्यूटिफुल डेफिनेशन है उसको कवर नहीं करता। जो नार्कोटिक अब्यूज है, कि ड्रग्स बोलते हैं, ड्रग एडिक्ट है, तो नार्कोटिक ड्रग्स के रेफरेंस में है ड्रग अब्यूज, कि बहुत सारे वैसे ड्रग्स हैं जो हैबिट फॉर्मिंग है, जैसे टोबैको है, बहुत सारे आपको नार्कोटिक ड्रग्स हैं जो बैंड है, टोबैको इज नॉट बैंड, लेकिन बहुत सारे जो अभी टीवी पे आ रहा है बैंड ड्रग्स हैं, अगर उसको आपने ले लिया तो बड़े बड़े लोगों को पुलिस पकड़ रही है, तो उनको आप यूज नहीं कर सकते हो, उनको आप खरीद नहीं सकते, तो उनका यूजेज तो पनिशेबल है बाय लॉ, लेकिन बहुत सारे ऐसे हैबिट फॉर्मिंग ड्रग्स हैं जैसे टोबैको, तो दैट्स आल्सो अ ड्रग अब्यूज। सो ड्रग अब्यूज एक कोई जनरल वर्ड है, आप गूगल में सर्च करके विकिपीडिया से देखिए, बहुत ज्यादा उसमें कोई समझाने का स्कोप नहीं है, इट्स जनरल टर्म, लाइक सोशियोलॉजी आप पढ़िए उसमें, और अगर कुछ वैसा फैक्ट आता है तो क्लास में शेयर करेंगे उसको। और कुछ है? So, if there are no questions, thank you. पढ़ते रहिए।
इसमें जो यूनिट टू में था नार्को टेस्ट, तो एनिमल्स में हम क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं सर?
फार्माकोलॉजी तो है, ये जो जितने भी ह्यूमन बींग्स में, एनिमल्स में नार्को टेस्ट नहीं पढ़ेंगे, मैंने एक एग्जाम्पल दिया सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम फार्माकोलॉजी का इम्पोर्टेंस बताने के लिए, ये जो छठे हुए बदमाश जो होते हैं, जैसे मैंने कोई चोरी करी है, मुझसे पूछोगे तो बताओ नहीं मैंने चोरी नहीं, तो अभी मैं फुल्ली कॉन्सियस हूँ तो बता रहा हूँ कि चोरी नहीं की है, बेटा से पूछूंगा कि, तो जो ये जो छठे हुए बदमाश होते हैं, अगर सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम जो आपकी अवेयरनेस, जो आपके कंट्रोल मैकेनिज्म को गाइड कर रहा है, उनको डिप्रेस कर रहे हैं, नींद में बड़बड़ाता है ना बहुत सारा, फुल्ली अवेयर आदमी भी नींद में बड़बड़ाता है, तो वही सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम का एक लेवल ऑफ डिप्रेशन है, जिसमें उसका ओवर योर थॉट, जो आप बोल रहे हैं उसमें आपका वॉलेंट्री कंट्रोल खत्म हो जाता है, लेकिन सब कॉन्सियस होता है, उसको थप्पड़ मारते हैं तब पूछते हैं कहाँ गया था, तो बताता है, फिर सो जाता है, फिर थप्पड़ मार, इस तरीके से पूछते हैं, तो वो क्या साइंस है, सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम को कैसे आप मॉड्यूलेट कर सकते हो, वो सारी चीजें सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम फार्माकोलॉजी में पढ़ेंगे, और एनिमल्स में नार्कोटिक्स नहीं करेंगे, परेशान नहीं होना। और कुछ पूछना? गुड, ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चंस, आपके अच्छे क्वेश्चंस मिले। चलिए आप पढ़िए, जो भी और टॉपिक्स हैं या फिर जो स्टडी मटेरियल्स हैं, अभी क्लास के बाद मैं अपलोड करूंगा, तो आप जो भी मोबाइल में देख सकते हैं। और एक हार्ड बुक जब भी मौका मिले, आइदर के डी त्रिपाठी और बी के रॉय और अच्छे संधु वाली बुक, बुक थोड़ी मोटी है, लेकिन मोटे बुक से घबराना नहीं है, टारगेट बांध दो कि 365 दिन या 5 साल में पढ़ना है, तो एक एक पेज अगर रोज पढ़े ना तो खत्म होना ही होना, और एक अच्छा वेटनेरियन बनना है, तो आपकी ऐसा नहीं है कि वेटनेरियन मतलब घोड़ा डॉक्टर से शर्माना नहीं है, इट्स ए प्रिविलेज, और हर कोई नहीं हमारे एनिमल्स का इलाज कर सकता है, और यू शुड नॉट बी अशेम्ड ऑफ योर प्रोफेशन, अगर अपने अपने स्टेटशिप से अगर आपको शर्म आती है, अपने प्रोफेशन से आती है, तो आप इसको ऊपर लेके नहीं जा सकते, ऐसे स्टॉलवर्ड्स हैं जिनको जिन जिनसे हर कोई मिलना चाहेगा, देयर वेटनेरियंस, और वो भी कहीं से अंडर ग्रेजुएट सिलेबस पढ़ के गए हैं, तो कोई साइंस अपने में खराब नहीं होता, हर एक साइंस में आप टॉप पे जा सकते हैं और आप में एबिलिटी है, आप कर सकते हैं वो सारे, इसीलिए जो भी है उसको डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे, ठीक है, चलिए, ओके, थैंक यू, ओके,
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर.